हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज मॉडल ऑक्सिलरी शाल शुड वील वुड। सब्जेक्ट टीचर नजन कमल बंसी। मॉडल ऑक्सिलरीज आर कैन कुड मे माइट शाल शुड will would must or used to need there watch it carefully and read the important information about modal auxiliary Modal auxiliaries express attitudes like permission, possibility, necessity, ability, etc. Modal auxiliaries come before the subject in questions. Modal auxiliaries can combine with an apostrophe T in the negative. Modal auxiliaries are termed defective verbs as they have no s in the third person singular. Modal auxiliaries are termed as defective verbs as they have no infinitive and ing form. Read it well. Try to understand it. All the features of modal auxiliaries. Modal auxiliary shall, should, will, could. Let's concentrate on shall and will. Shall is used in the first person to express pure future. For example, I shall pay you later. We shall see you again. Will is used in the second and third person to express pure future. For example, you will get good marks in English. He will present his project tomorrow. In present day English, will is used in all persons. I will visit the zoo. Shall. Shall is used in second and third person to express a command, a promise or threat. For example, he shall not enter my house again. Command. You shall have a holiday tomorrow. Promise. You shall be punished for this. Threat. Note that these uses are old-fashioned and formal. They are generally avoided in modern English. But we must know all this information, all this about shall. Shall. Shall is used in the second and third person to ask after the will, that desire of the person addressed. For example, shall I open the window? Do you wish me to open it? Which dress shall I wear? What is your suggestion? Shall the workers work now? Will. Will is used to express volition, that is willpower. For example, I will carry your luggage. Will. I will try to help you. Promise. I will overcome this bad situation. Determination. Second, will is used to express characteristic habit. He will do nothing but play games on computer. She will sit for hours reading the books. B. Point 3. Assumption or probability. This will be the book you want, I suppose. That will be the chief guest, I think. Will you indicates an invitation or a request. Will you have coffee? Will you lend me your bike? Now let's concentrate on should and would. Should and would are used as the past equivalents of shall and will. I expected that I should get a first class. He said he would carry my books. She would sit for hours reading the books. Should is used in all persons to express duty or obligation. And model sentences are here for you. Should is used in all persons to express duty or obligation. We should obey our parents. You should keep your promise. Students should obey their teachers. Should and would. In the clauses of condition, should is used to express a supposition that may not be true. If it should rain, they will not come. If he should see me here, he will be annoyed. More polite form of want. I should like you to help her. I would like you to help her. Should and would. Use of should and would. Let's concentrate. A past obligation that was not fulfilled. Use of should have been. For example, you should have been more careful. Next, should expresses probability. For example, he should be on the ground now. Or you can say another example, he should be in the library now. Next, would is also used as follows. More polite than will you. We can use would. For example, would you lend me your car, please? Next, would after wish expresses a strong desire. Would after wish. It is a strong desire. It expresses a strong desire. For example, I wish you would not chatter so much. Children, today we have learned model auxiliaries, The features of modal auxiliaries. Today, we have focused on shall, should, will, would. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Read all the modal sentences very well. Try to understand it well. Thank you. Goodbye.